Welcome back. A super moon, a blue moon, a lunar eclipse tomorrow. We are in for a lunar trifecta, the first of its kind in 35 years. And joining me to talk about this very rare occurrence is NASA scientist Dr. Jake Bleacher. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. This is a trifecta, so I'm assuming like those that are really in love with space are going to be all giddy. Are you one of them?
Oh, yeah, this is just a rare event that for those of us, as you said, who like to look at the moon, this is great. We've got the super moon. The moon will be about 14% larger and 30% brighter than normal because it's closer to the Earth. The blue moon, meaning that this is the second full moon of the month, and then it will be taking on a reddish color as it passes through the shadow of the Earth.
Wow. So the eclipse begins tomorrow morning. For those that want to set their alarm and go look, our time, 4:51 our time. Now, when you go out there and you try to see this, what's the best way to look at it?
Unlike the solar eclipse last year, you don't have to do anything special. Just get your alarm set, get out there, and then look to the west. The moon will be heading towards moonset to the west. And as you are watching, you will see the moon slowly take on a reddish color, again, as it's passing through the shadow of the Earth into eclipse.
Well, just we talked about how this is rare, but really, it's really rare. I mean, the last time this happened was in 1866 when all of these events occurred at the same time. And it's not going to happen again until, like, what, 2037? Is that when it'll happen again?
Yep. Yep, yeah, so it's, you know, you want to, if this is interesting to you, you should get out there and take a look because you won't get another chance for a while.
All right, West Coast is going to get the best show. East Coasters will see a partial one. We're stuck right in the middle, so that's probably a good place to see it as well. What are scientists going to be looking at? I'm sure you look at it different than we would look at it. What are you going to be looking at? Because I'm assuming we still have a lot to learn about the moon.
Sure. This is a unique event, as we said, so scientifically this is a unique event as well. If you look at the moon, you can see that it's not the same everywhere, so there are different surface materials. And as that moon passes into the shadow of the Earth, it will rapidly experience a temperature change and cool off really quickly. So what we'll be looking at is how those temperatures change across the surface of the moon, and that will tell us about the physical properties in different areas. So this is a good time for us to be watching.
Yes, watching, and a lot of people will be taking pictures as well, so we want to invite our viewers to share those pictures, and we'll be sharing them as this happens as well tomorrow morning. Thank you so much for joining us here on Good Day. Appreciate it. You can find a link to NASA and our website, or on our website, I should say, fox4news.com. Going to be pretty impressive, Chip.